What's up, everybody? My name's CJ Faison, and welcome to my vlog channel. If you're looking for my main channel, the link is down there in the description, so go check that out. If you just stumbled upon this video and you don't know what in the hell I'm talking about or what the Honeycutt Farm is, there's gonna be a link to part 1 through 6 down in the description as well. But this is my vlog channel. This is where I come to you behind the scenes. Obviously, most of you all know what the hell was that? That was weird. Most of you all know what area this is behind me. This is one of my offices I have. It's at the Motivated Eyewear headquarters. It's a Motivated Eyewear. It's the brand that I own. Obviously, I wear it every day. There are tons of questions about the Honeycutt Farm series. What the hell happened? Are you going back? All kinds of stuff. And I'm about to lay all of it out here on the table for all of you. I'm answering a lot of the questions, and I'm also going to be telling you about things that not necessarily I would like to tell you, at least. First and foremost, after our Sonny and I's weekend at the Honeycutt Farm, everything that could have gone wrong did go wrong, in our opinion. We were both hurt. I'm actually filming this vlog right here on November 8th, 2020. I have to tell you all this because this is super, super important. The actual weekend we spent at the Honeycutt Farm was filmed about 2 months ago. I contemplated on releasing the footage at all. I actually thought it went so terribly wrong and mortifying that I didn't really know if I wanted to live with that on camera. Just complete and utter fear. I've been scared at places before, but that place there, when I look back at the footage, I don't even know why I went there. I don't even know why I went back for a second time, or not second time, but for a second season. I don't know what I was thinking, and a lot of you all, first of all, killed me in the comments section. I mean, you all cleaned the streets up with me on this one. You all were at my throat for leaving Sonny. It was not my intention at all. Technically, I didn't leave Sonny, he left me. Do I think I did the right thing? Absolutely not. I should have probably... Now looking back, I should have followed him. But when you go to a place that you are so drawn to, that it's scary as hell, but you want to be there so bad that like it's almost like you can't leave, that's a problem. And that's a feeling that I am sure 99.9% of people who are watching this right now have probably never felt in their life. When you feel this feeling, trust me when I say this, it does not just... Oh, it goes away. Oh, this is nice. It's nothing like that. So first of all, I don't know if it's something that comes over me and attaches itself to me when I'm there. I really don't know. Here lately, for the past 2 months, we've been filming at some various other locations across the country. And I've been having like a lot of very strange, very weird things happen to me. I'm trying to play it off like it's not happening, because I can feel better about myself at the end of the day like that. So that's the one thing I did want to just kind of cover, that if I would have been in a proper state of mind at any other location, I would have definitely left with Sonny. But being that I own that property, being that I felt comfortable but yet scared there, that is exactly why I stayed. I don't exactly know if if there's an energy or an entity that like follows me, but it literally like it draws my energy so much. I have a hard time talking to all of you about this because this is something super personal that happened to me. It's something super personal that happened to Sonny. So obviously part 1 through 5 everyone saw. Part 6 was gonna be the footage of me literally crawling back to my RV. I crawled and crawled and crawled. Now, when you see my camera go down right here into the grass, that is a point where I don't really remember. I remember getting to the RV and I was in extreme amount of pain. It was very, very weird. Now, to give you all a little bit of history about me, I've had some health issues pertaining to my brain. So in NASCAR, when I raced in NASCAR, I had a couple of concussions there. And when I've raced some local dirt track races, I've also had a couple concussions there. So, you know, my neurologist basically told me that, you know, one more solid hit to the head and you could be pretty much done for the rest of your life. And that's scary. That's really what shook me to my core with this video, is that something hit me in the back of the head. I don't know if it was an object. I have no idea. I watch back the footage 1,000 times, and I cannot figure out what the hell hit me.
It hit me right across the back of the head. Now, most of this right here was swollen up. I had a gash on the back of my neck. And again, it scared me. When I came to, I was in a lot of pain. I reached back to feel my neck. As soon as I did, I felt a liquid, which obviously was blood. And I looked at my hand and I'm like, I went into panic mode at that point and I started yelling for Sunny. From the time of there to the time I blacked out to where I don't really remember. I remember falling down, but I almost felt like I was trying to lay down. And from that point to the RV, I don't remember anything. When I got back to the RV, I laid outside the RV apparently. Sunny had come out. I remember this part for some reason. I looked up as he's coming out the door and he had sheer terror on his face. And that's something I will never get out of my head, is the terror that I saw in his face when he saw me bleeding. Oh my gosh.
It gives me chills like I got right now. I mean, Sunny is my best friend. Like, we film together, we hang out together, we go to lunch together. I mean, we travel together, we spend so much time together. Life on the road and filming these videos is all fun and games until somebody gets hurt, and then, you know, it kind of gives you a reality check. I have contemplated many times since then, is it even worth continuing filming haunted videos? That question can be tossed up in any form. Me going into an abandoned place that has no haunted history at all, I could fall through the floor, whatever. You can always get hurt no matter what you're doing. I could leave the office right now, I could get my pickup truck and get in a car accident. It is what it is. It's like the risk that you take for what you do.
I want to address one thing. The first comment that comes up on this video says, who else agrees with Sunny that CJ is totally different when he is here?
When I'm there in person, I feel completely normal. Completely normal. I'm scared. I'm happy to be there. I want to be there. But it's not like I feel like I act normal. So when I watch back the footage, I'm like, I'm such an asshole, and I'm an asshole at this farm. Every time I've ever been there, I've been a complete asshole, no matter who it is that I'm filming with. That was the first thing. So I want to apologize to everyone out there that if you watch any of my other videos, you know that is not me. That is something that is trying to take control over me. I had to put that out there. Another comment said, I wouldn't be surprised if Sunny doesn't talk to you for a good while. He's literally scared shitless. You need to leave that place alone for good. The comment right under that is basically saying that Sunny and CJ are no longer friends. That is false. We are still best friends. We have filmed together many times since then, and we will continue to do so. And that's kind of wraps that question up, because that was going in the comment threads pretty good, like that we weren't filming together anymore, but that was absolutely bogus. We are filming. Next question is, statement I'm gonna read off is, if you truly think of someone as a friend, when they run, you run. Together is better than letting them alone. Don't order them around. Again, I have a type A personality. I run businesses. I have ever since I was like 12. I've had my own business since I was 11 or 12 years old, so I'm very forward with everything that I say and do. Sometimes the way that I come across is not the way that I mean. The tone of my voice also may not match the actual narrative of what I'm trying to get across. So keep that in mind when you do watch my videos. I would greatly appreciate that. The next question that I had was, is the house on the Honeycutt property? Absolutely it is. At the time, we did not realize that. When Sunny freaked out in part one and started running, I was so confused on what was going on. I thought he had actually seen somebody on the farm. Maybe that was like gonna try to shoot us or something. I don't know. But when he started running, it spooked me, and I'm like, oh gosh, like what are we about to run into here? And he's like, turn your light off, and screaming and hollering and running through the woods. Thank goodness we had sweatshirts on, because we would have got cut up by all the briars that we were running through. It was ridiculous. Now, there are other buildings on the farm and the property, but I have not even remotely checked into those. I mean, I've looked inside of them, but I've not actually gone and filmed a physical video. It's kind of boring. They're like big empty barns, basically. It's nothing too crazy. I didn't feel any energy there, but I really want to get across to this is I don't know exactly if I'll ever go back. And I say that because I have said this twice now that, oh, I'm never going back. And they always say never say never. I understand why. I want to play one clip for you really quick that a lot of you commented on, and I never even picked up on this when I was watching back the footage. I'm gonna show you this clip in the audio, and you can listen to it, you can see it. It's like when I take my hat and I turn it this way, it's like I was, so many of you are like, CJ, at that point in time, like, it was taking control of you, like you were possessed, stuff like that. I don't know if I've ever been possessed, but I think this is maybe one of the moments where I was really fighting, like an energy there. And it can happen. Possession can happen. And it will happen, especially if you let it take control over you. And me personally, I think I let a lot at the Honeycutt Farm control me. I want to mentally think that no, I don't, and I'm very strong, and I'm very strong-willed that I won't let it happen. But it is happening. I can't really avoid that. Trust me, I try. I can feel an energy. So go ahead and roll this clip. Who doesn't want Sunny here? Tell me your name. You all know my personality. You all also have said that you don't think it's a good idea for anyone to ever step foot in the Honeycutt Farm ever again, and I completely agree with that. I respect that. But I don't think I can listen to that. There's something about that place. I'm telling you all, there's something about that place. I want to go back. I don't know when it will be, but it will be alone. And no one will know I'm there. And I just want you all to wish me luck. I'm going to record from the very front gate the whole way through. I'm going to spend the night there. A lot of you have said that the spirits are trying to draw people away and push them away. A lot of people have said that there's an extremely evil energy at the Honeycutt Farm, which is absolutely true. And they're trying to get me alone. I want to find out why. Never spent the night alone at the Honeycutt Farm. But I think it's time I do. What I've gone through there is tough. What I feel there is heavy, but I don't think that I can bulldoze this place in without knowing the true answers and the true stories behind what those spirits or energies or the devil himself is doing there. I don't know. But I want you all to do one thing. I want you guys to comment below your opinions about the Honeycutt Farm. I want to know what you think. Why do you think that the spirits or demonic energies that are there, why are they trying to get me alone? I want to know some information. I know a lot of you have done a ton of research in the paranormal field, probably more research year-wise than I've been alive. And if you're one of those people, I would like you to reach out in the comment section and comment that. What exactly do you think is going on? I want to read every single comment before I whoa. I want every single one of you to comment. I'm feeling really weird right now. I also wanted to let everyone know before I log off of this video here. Again, I don't know when I'm gonna film there. I'm not gonna say anything. Not on social media, not to Sunny, not to any of my friends, my family, or anything. Because no one will let me go there alone. I can promise you that after everything that has happened. What I do want to let you all know is here at my brand and my company, Motivated. I don't know if y'all can hear that, but there's like sirens. Anyway, if you all can and will, go to shopmotivated.com. All of the Honeycutt merchandise will no longer ever be available ever again. So back to what I was saying before my camera died. All of the Honeycutt merchandise, the hoodies that are still left, there's not many of them. Go to shopmotivated.com. Get them while they last because they're never going to be produced ever again. This is literally the last run of Honeycutt hoodies ever produced. The same thing with the neck gaiters that you can like wear as masks. Like those are so cool. I wear them pretty much every time that I go out in public. I just put it right up over my nose and you're good to go. So go get those as well. Use promo code Honeycutt at checkout. That will get you 50% off of the Honeycutt neck gaiters. So I mean that when I say it. Go get them now before they are all gone. No more merch is being made for the Honeycutt farm. And I am going back one final time. And I feeling pretty heavy about it, but it's something that I feel that I have to do. Sorry for my energy being lower in this video, but I also wanted to say that I love you all very much. Thank you for supporting my main channel. Thank you for supporting this vlog channel, and thank you for supporting my life and me. And I hope that I can take you all on more adventures here soon. And I hope you all stay safe, wash your hands. I love y'all, and I'll see y'all in the next video.